No, absolutely not. But Shrek has been dominant. He's 2-0 on Captain L. 3-0. He's been putting in work in his own region, losing only a handful of times. This guy is nigh unstoppable, so we'll have to see what he does against ESAM. It'll be exciting to watch.
And of course, ESAM on a killer run in the opening months of Smash Ultimate. I'd say, without even thinking about it, top 20, probably higher, possibly higher.
Oh, absolutely.
But yeah, you can expect to see this guy very high in the PGR, and Strike, if he manages to take this set, that would be a huge win, not only for for him, but for Canada. Wow, Shine Spike
in
2019,
awesome.
Man.
All right.
Oh. That's going to hit a little bit low. And, of course, scoop up that illusion. We're going to see Strike losing the first stock here. Of course, Canada behind him. But once he starts heating up, you'll hear this crowd get louder.
Yeah, oh, absolutely. As soon as he takes a stock, we are actually going to blow up. And, oh, no! Getting gimped off the bottom of the stage there. And as we said, Strike has that Pichu experience, but I don't know if he's actually played a good Pikachu before.
Right, yeah, if he's got a winning record on Captain L. That's one thing, but Captain L not really using too much Pikachu in this game. We saw him just busted out game 5 against Ally right before this, but still not his bread and butter.
No, and Strike has definitely not played his Pikachu before. So this being a somewhat new matchup for him, and definitely not a new matchup for ESAM. We've seen him go game 5 or win sets against the best foxes in the business. So Strike's going to have his work cut out for him.
Man, that back hit of the up smash almost closing the door on ESAM, but it was so weak that, of course, it's not going to do it just yet at 120.
And this is so tough, that down air sending him off stage. ESAM's edge guarding is so strong, every option being covered right now.
Yeah, ESAM, of course, one of the best off the stage in the game, but also someone who plays a character that you probably don't know the matchup against, right?
No, and, absolutely.
And especially with a character like Fox, ESAM's strength as a player really shine against him.
Oh, the thunder coming out frame one, breaking that string up, and now ESAM has Strike off stage again. No jump, but gets back.
The auto cancel there. Oh, drags him with forward air. Okay. He's got some cool stuff, but of course, too little too late at this point.
Oh, gosh.
See that Thunder, man.
Oh, comboing out of the Shine Thunder, though. Strike's seen some things.
Oh, almost with the double parry. If he had just been aware of that landing hitbox. Wow, a bear gonna kill him. Straight up.
You could tell he was holding in. He was trying to come down with that Nair. And so, you know, the DI wasn't there, unfortunately. And that's when you see wacky kills like that. Pikachu's up air being a little stronger than it was in the last game as well.
A good bit stronger, and up throw too.
Yeah,
say the same for that.
Absolutely, yeah. Two really good new tools at Pikachu's disposal, as if he didn't already have enough new good ones.
Yeah, he was a solid character in Smash 4 for sure, and if you ask ESAM, you know, potentially somewhere in the top 5 or 8 in the game, I don't know.
I wouldn't ask ESAM.
Yeah, ESAM, of course, always very strong opinions of his own character, and just in general, you know, a guy who's
not afraid
to voice what he thinks.
Yeah, he goes in confident, and that's something you have to respect regardless of who's playing. If they believe in their character, that's also kind of a tactic that some people use to not blame their character on losing, and it actually helps them get better.
I really like that. I feel like too many people are quick to discredit their character, say they're overrated. But man, if you're out here winning, obviously you believe in this character if you're still playing them, right?
Oh, absolutely, man, absolutely. And we're seeing ESAM with a hot start, trying to read the jump with the Thunder.
That was clean that he missed himself with the Thunder, so the Shine didn't actually make it hit him.
Oh man, and ESAM's tricks off stage, allowing him to get back almost scot-free.
Best character's recovery, very reliable. Of course, if you just stick a big fat hitbox in the middle of it, you can intercept pretty easily, but he moves so quickly, he's got so many angles, it's pretty difficult to pin him down.
Okay, bust out the up smash after the dash tag, but ESAM still with a hefty lead, and after getting that drag down neutraler, he gets the down smash. Pikachu, man.
Yeah, like we were talking about before, good character in Smash 4, right? But he's only received improvements in Ultimate. Downers, a spike, fair and up air kill, up throw kills earlier, like, man.
And it's even things you don't even think about, like, yeah, like the up air and up throw killing earlier aren't even the main attractions of this character being better. It's
new
insane.
Nair, dude.
Yeah.
The new Nair really opens up so much for him, just as you see the landing into the smash for kills. But if you land into Fox's up smash, that will also
that
kill
will
you.
Also be a kill. And actually, a fun fact, I found out Fox's up smash is called flip kick.
Really?
And Zero's down B is flip jump.
And I think if you do the down B, it's flip kick also. You know, the second hit.
Yeah, so we may see a couple Nair flip kicks come through.
That's funny, man. You know what his back throw is called?
No.
All right, well, it's not safe for work, so we'll leave that out for now. But yeah, guys, Google the Prima Guide or like the move names in Melee, and you'll find out what Fox's back throw is called.
That's really funny. But we see ESAM off stage. Luckily, Strike getting hit back on stage. Not going to lose his stock quite yet. Up smash coming through. Strike with a little bit of pressure, but the nair.
This is getting a bit out of hand in game two as well. Yeah, no. Forward tilt just going to send him off to the right side.
That's tough, man. And ESAM is so good at catching that Fox recovery. He knows what the mix-ups are. And one thing you see with these top players is they never miss when they have that read, right? And it's just so consistent against Fox. It's so hard. You have to be playing so well to get around someone who just knows what you're going to do.
Yeah, ESAM's edge guard's absolutely surgical. Steady hand for sure.
Absolutely, man. Okay, we see strike. Sign of life here. Got a little bit of a string, but no kill on that up smash.
Yeah, trying to strike back, but not working out for him. ESAM just...
Okay. Platform to platform.
Flip kick.
Absolute knowledge from Strike to get that up smash.
We got to call it flip kick.
Yeah, we have to now, man. We have to. All right, gets forward smashed out of pressure there. ESAM in the advantage. Strike back off stage. Going to hit with that back air. Not dead yet.
And the forward air, more knockback in Smash Ultimate, of course, and that's going to be the end of Strike. Two games down already. This has been blindingly fast.
Oh, it's been insanely fast, man. And unfortunately for Strike, you know, this is this matchup familiarity. This is Pikachu, who I'm sure some would argue is a hard matchup. And this is ESAM, right? And so he's got
the pinnacle of this character.
Yeah, he's got such a mountain to climb.
Yo,
he's going Yoshi, so
know.
Strike switches to Young Link. ESAM trying to swag, might live to regret it.
He just gave me one of those looks. Like,
oh,
yeah, I know I got this. Strike, of course, one of the best players in all of Canada, I believe, finishing within the top 10 nationally for Smash 4, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, so ESAM just saying, man, this whole country is under my thumb right now.
Doesn't have anything on me, but this Young Link starting off strong with a quick 60%. And do not count out Strike's Young Link. This character is almost as good as his Fox.
I like the character switch, regardless of who ESAM was going to go for this third game here.
Absolutely.
I think Young Link is great against Yoshi, great against Pikachu. You know, he's got all these things that can interrupt their mobility, which is really the crown jewel of these characters.
Well, and one thing I like about Strike is he didn't accept that he would lose, right? He could have stayed Fox and been like, oh, I'll probably lose to Yoshi, whatever. He switched. He wants to win. He counterpicked even though he's down, and ESAM was almost trying to meme on him.
Yeah, he looks like he's trying to meme on him, man. That's literally what's happening. And that face from ESAM, too. Man, a back air to up tilt, though. Also want to point out how a few seconds ago, ESAM swung an up smash at Young Link's down air on the way down, just ripped clean through it, hit him like in the side of the arms, didn't even interact with his sword. So this man's spacing. Extra clean.
Those Tims are big, man. Those Tims are big, extra large.
Yeah, Yoshi definitely wearing like a size 18.
No, the drag down back air into up smash. ESAM kind of feeling himself.
Link with some boots of his own, though. See that neutral air, one of the best moves this character brings to the table.
Absolutely, what's insane too is boomerang. Even if that hits on shield, it's less than negative 10.
Yeah, it's very quick to end, and it also does an obscene amount of damage. So, of course, you're gonna be in block stun for a hot minute.
All right, nair out of pressure. Strike mounting quite the lead right now. ESAM maybe regretting this pick.
I like how he locked him down with the arrows, waiting for the boomerang to return. But yeah, man, this is looking like Strike's game. Of course, we still have quite a bit of gameplay left here.
Oh my gosh, the down air not doing it yet. Yoshi's heavy, and Young Link can struggle to kill sometimes.
All his weight's in his nose and his shoes.
The up air still not doing it. ESAM at 180, but forward smash will take the stock. Strike only at 31%.
That didn't even look like a true punish. I think ESAM was just pressing buttons afterward. Strike gonna clip that up with a sword, something Yoshi unfortunately doesn't have. There's a lot of disjoints. Ooh.
That forward smash punish though could be bad as Strike is forced off stage. Up B's early, but still off stage. ESAM gonna be looking for something big.
Almost caught a big edge guard.
Had me real scared for a second. Goes for this forward smash. Strike wisely rolling past. Gonna shoot an arrow. These trades. Strike will take them.
All right, not even gonna challenge that up smash. He learned his lesson from last time.
Absolutely, man.
If properly spaced horizontally, you can rip clean through your down air.
Oh, probably. That thing is huge.
It already happened, yeah.
Yeah, we saw it. All right, the forward air. Can you confirm it? Yeah, but not gonna kill quite yet. I thought that might have been it.
Just enough weight on Young Link to survive. It's like on the lower end of midweight, higher end of lightweight type of character.
What I love about Strike in this matchup right now is he's confirming off of every little hit. If he gets one, you can almost count on him getting another.
I love how Young Link can do full screen conversions with his projectiles, man, half screen, really.
It's crazy, but the back hit of Nair taking Strike out, a very reasonable 150. But Strike!
You're crazy, dude. All right, here comes ESAM's turn.
Oh, no.
40 already.
Strike dodges it, but ESAM catches him with the egg. No jump still. and 72, man.
That should do it. Yes. Yeah. Okay, going to get hit from higher up on the screen than he did before, and that's just enough for that downer to take him out. We're going to see Strike put himself on the board. He's still hanging on. Canada's still living right now.
I'm not going to lie. When you try to disrespect someone like that and it doesn't work, you look like a huge goon.
You do.
And now he has to figure out if he wants to stay and try and goon him out again for the pride, or if he wants to just guarantee the win with Pikachu, and he will do it with Pikachu.
ESAM making the smart choice here, not putting pride over reason.
Yeah, no, absolutely not. But now Strike back on this mountain to climb.
Back with Fox, interesting choice. I figured he would probably stay Young Link, but maybe he only did that in response to the Yoshi. Just like the sequence of events before Game 3, it looked like he was already just dead set on picking Young Link, and they locked him in like immediately after each other. But I don't know, maybe the Fox is for the Pikachu, the Young Link's for the Yoshi.
Hey man, who am I to question someone that made it this far?
Exactly. Well, I mean, technically you are exactly in the same spot of bracket if he loses here.
But no, man, he's doing good and definitely earning ESAM's respect on that one. Showing that, you know, you can't just go secondaries on me, right? You're going to have to pull out the Pikachu and you're going to have to earn it.
From the looks of this match, it looks like he might not be able to go his main on him either. Strike turning up just a bit.
Oh!
Yeah, that neutral air, not enough stage to work with.
If that had sent the other way, that would have been a kill. But ESAM wisely quick attacking back to stage, and now he's going to be an advantage. Catches the air dodge down.
Yeah, you're not going to fool ESAM with that, man. The Brawl air dodge against the Brawl player, not as good as you might think.
All right, coming back on. Almost clips him with the back air through the Thunder Jolt. Smart from Strike, but not quite the precision he was looking for. This is the down air. ESAM back at ledge. Goes for the up smash. Thought something was coming. Back air to shield, going to send Strike off stage.
It's all about how much he can mix these recoveries up, and right there, I like the drift back, giving himself more time, going to respond with back air as soon as he gets on the stage, and we've got Strike with a stock lead for the first time in the set, at least against the Pikachu.
Absolutely, and that was so clean, the empty hop to another back air, with the air dodge off stage, ESAM makes it back.
I thought ESAM dropped the second hit of his quick attack there for a second, and might have fallen to his death at 11%.
Could have been devastating, man. But ESAM missing the re-grab, not getting the full juice off of those lightning loops. But Strike offstage without a jump, he's going to have to eat these hits instead of dying.
Drags him down, but the last hit of fair not connecting. Going to be negative enough on hit for Strike to hit him.
ESAM misses the down air, but catches the roll in with the forward smash.
Just sensing the panic. Oh, and if I'm Strike, I'm definitely panicking right now. Missing the edge on that side B. He wanted to be so delicate and make sure to sweet spot it vertically, not poke his head above the edge.
It's
but man,
so
it cost
tough, man. Because if you poke above just a little bit, Pikachu can forward tilt you. And Strike definitely wanting to avoid that situation, but ends up putting himself in an even worse one.
See, dash attack to up smash, the really chunky but short combos there.
All right, gonna get in up air. You see, I'm throwing out a thunder. That was a wacky thunder. I kind of like it though. Kind of set up a wall between him and Strike, just in case Strike was thinking about going out there.
Exactly, man. That's been in the ESAM playbook for years. He's not afraid to take a couple risks off the stage. He knows he'll always be able to recover.
Absolutely, man. And Strike almost getting lapped in percent at this point, but gets an up smash. Doesn't quite kill.
Another thunder wall. Oh, but ESAM going to cut the quick attack short. Do only one hit, and that might do it. Yes, it will. We're going to see ESAM going to winner's side of top eight.
Yeah, 3-1 coming in from that set. Very nice confirm from ESAM. He does not miss the